The film begins in 1957 with some tourists driving through the Nevada desert. On the same road, a military convoy is traveling to its destination. They reach a government sanctuary barred from all sides in the middle of the desert. The security keeps them from entering the sanctuary. They open fire on the security guards and drive their vehicles into the barred area. The military takes two people, namely Indiana Jones and his friend George Michael, Mac, out of the car, whom they have kidnapped. Jones informs Mac that he learned from the language that the soldiers are Russian soldiers dressed in American military uniforms. A little later, a girl named Irina Spalko arrives, and she introduces herself to Jones and Mac. She asks Jones if he knows this place, and he does not respond. She tries to hypnotize him, but to no avail. After that, the military, followed by Spalko, walks towards a big garage where several wooden boxes have been kept. It is a secret warehouse named Hangar 51 where the American government keeps dangerous weapons. Spalko wants Jones to take her to the box with the corpses of aliens. Jones tells her he knows nothing about the corpses. She says 10 years ago, he examined these dead bodies. Jones tells the military that he does not know about the aliens, but he can tell them how to find the box. Jones tells Spalko that the box is made from such metals that they attract the powder inside the bullets. He asks the soldiers to give him bullets, and he takes out the powder. He blows the powder in the air, and he follows the powder, which leads him to a box. Spalko rips open the seal on the alien's corpse, and a hand comes out. While the soldiers are busy looking at the alien, Jones snatches a gun from a soldier and aims at Spalko. Mac betrays Jones, and he sides with the military. He tells Jones to surrender, and Jones throws the gun down. However, the gun starts shooting by itself, and in the meantime, he flees. He climbs the piled-up boxes and then jumps on the jeep. The chief commander, Dovshenko, runs after him, and they fight until they fall into a rocky testing area. In the meantime, the rocket countdown starts when Dovshenko mistakenly falls onto its menu. The soldiers run towards Jones, but they get killed by the fire the rocket exerts. The rocket vehicle sets out towards the desert, taking Jones ahead of it. The next morning, he walks towards a nearby town. He enters a house and sees everything, including humans, made from plastic. He hears a siren, which is circulating news that in 10 seconds a nuclear bomb will be dropped on the town. Jones sees a Russian vehicle, and he waves at them to get out, but they do not stop the car. Having no way around, he hides in a fridge that is lined with lead. The explosion takes place, and the fridge is pushed away. Later, American military personnel rescues him, and he is taken to a nearby airbase. He is washed to rid his body of nuclear radiation. The Federal Board of Investigation asks him what he was doing in the blast zone. He gives them the details of Irina Spalko. Jones returns to his city, and he is a history teacher at Marshall College. While he is taking class, the principal of the college, Charles Stanforth, calls him and tells him that he has been fired from his job. Despondent, he packs his luggage and goes towards the train station to go to another city. An adult boy named Mutt Williams on a bike arrives at the station and informs Jones that his friend, Professor Oxley, is in danger. He tells Jones that some people have kidnapped him. They go to a cafeteria and tell Jones that Oxley found a crystal skull in Peru but has since been kidnapped along with Mutt's mother, Marion. Meanwhile, two Russian agents walk up to them to arrest them. Jones and Mutt play tricks to fight a boy and flee. They drive the car through the college campus, and as the police arrive, the Russian agents run away. After that, they reach the house of Jones, and they try to learn more about the crystal skulls. They learn about the grave of Francis de Orellana, a conquistador who searched for actor. They board a flight to Peru and visit the mental prison where Oxley was kept last time. They go to the room where Oxley stayed and find some triangles and squares drawn on the floor. They come to know that the grave is near the prison. At night, they go to the graveyard, but some people attack them. Jones scares them away, and they go into a cave. In the cave, they find the skeletons of Orellana and her men. They find the crystal skull, and Jones says today's machinery cannot make such skulls. As they come out of the cave, Mac arrests both of them. He takes Jones to Irina Spalko, who is in the Soviet camp in the Amazon jungle. Spalko tells Jones that the crystal skull was made by aliens and that it is the real skull of aliens too. She says the skull has the power of telepathy, and she wants Russia to win the Cold War against America with the help of the skull. She meets him with Marion and Oxley. It is revealed that Jones knew Marion for the last 20 years, and even then, they almost got married. Irina wants Jones to inquire from Oxley about the Akator city. But Oxley seems mentally unstable. Jones holds a page before Oxley, and he draws a map with the help of which they can go to Akator. Meanwhile, Mutt sets fire to the camp with a lantern. They flee from the camp. When they are running in the forest, Jones and Marion fall into a quagmire. Mutt takes them out of the quagmire with the help of a snake. Unintentionally, Oxley goes to the Soviet camp and brings Irina and her soldiers into the quagmire. They arrest Jones, Marion, Oxley, and Mutt. The next day, the convoy of military personnel move to another station, with Jones, Marion, Mutt, and Oxley sitting in a truck. Marion tells Mutt that Jones is his father. Dovshenko tries to silence them, but Jones kicks him in the face, causing him to pass out. They get control over the truck, and Jones launches a rocket at the tree cutter machine. There is a fight between Jones and his people in Irina and her soldiers. Jones jumps on Mac's vehicle and holds him, hostage. During the battle, their vehicles strike a mountain surrounded by poisonous ants. Luckily, Irina climbs a tree, but the ants attack her companion. While Jones, Marion, Oxley, and Mutt are running toward the river, Dovshenko jumps over them from the vehicle. Jones hits hard on Dovshenko's head, and the ants consume him. Marion rescues Mutt, Oxley, and Jones in a car and crashes it into a river. Irina and her companions also get off the mountain to the river. It turns out it is a waterfall, and Oxley tells them through riddles that there are three downward turns in the waterfall. One way or another, they come out of the water, although tired to death. Oxley then points to a mountain from where they can reach Akator. After that, they enter a cave, where they see paintings of aliens drawn on the walls. While they are looking at the paintings, suddenly the tribesmen appear and start to follow them. The tribesmen besiege them. And Jones asks Oxley how he escaped from them when he came there for the first time. Oxley then scares away the tribesmen by showing them the crystal skull. Next, Jones, Mac, Marion, and Oxley hike a pyramid. They have to solve a puzzle by pulling the small stones out of the pyramid so that the sand flows out of it, causing it to penetrate the ground. As the sand drains from the pyramid, the minarets begin to rise, and Jones and his team enter. They then reach a temple that is full of treasures and artifacts. According to Jones, the aliens were archaeologists who researched human civilization. Jones touches the skull with a big door, and it starts to open. They enter a temple, and shortly after, Irina arrives there. She takes the skull from Jones at gunpoint and returns it to a beheaded alien. The alien thanks them and says he wants to give them some power. Irina tells the alien that she wants to know about the technology of aliens. Suddenly, a spaceship starts in the center of the temple. Jones and his companions flee after the alien burns Irina to ashes. The entire area gradually penetrates the water. Jones and his companions run away from the pyramid, and they see it destroyed in the distance. They see the spaceship come out of the pyramid. Everything is floating in the air. Jones tells Mutt that aliens descended on Earth not only to grab gold but also to spread knowledge about their civilization. The aliens seem to have returned to their world. The scene shifts to a marriage ceremony where Jones and Marion are getting married. The movie ends there. If you like our video, kindly subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss our new video. Thanks.